Hi, thanks for joining us for PEC News, where we bring you the latest on events, education, and outreach for PEC and the Texas Hill Country. On today's broadcast, we learn more about the beautiful insects you've likely seen fly in the co-op, monarch butterflies, and how PEC helps their migration. For the latest, let's check in with reporter Matt Gonzalez. Matt?
Thanks, Celeste. I'm here on location at PEC headquarters in Johnson City at the Monarch Butterfly Way Station, where butterflies are flying all around me.
Wow, they really are beautiful. We know butterflies are flying insects that help pollinate plants, flowers, and crops. But what else is there to know?
Well, to become a butterfly, they must go through a life cycle. The four stages of a butterfly's life cycle are adult, egg, pupa, and larva. But these are not in order. Pause the video and discuss with your class to determine what is the correct order. Did you say egg, larva, pupa, and then adult? If so, you're right. In the egg stage, the eggs are laid on leaves of a plant. They are tiny, about the size of a pencil tip, and are usually yellow or off-white in color. The next stage is the larva stage. This stage lasts about 9 to 14 days when the egg becomes a caterpillar. Did you know a caterpillar has 6 pairs of eyes? Even though they have many eyes, their eyesight is poor, and instead use their antenna to help them move around. Once a caterpillar is fully grown, it forms itself into a pupa or chrysalis. This is where it changes through the metamorphosis to make up the parts of a butterfly. Once the full transformation has taken place inside the pupa, the final stage of the life cycle takes place when the adult butterfly emerges. What do you think happens after the 4 stages of the butterfly's life cycle? Pause here and discuss with your classmates. A monarch butterfly, like this one, migrates through PEC's 8,100 square mile service area, and a way station like this one attracts monarch butterflies while conserving and protecting their habitat.
It's interesting to learn about the 4 life cycle stages and how each is unique.
Yes, PEC is also taking measures to help conserve monarchs too.
That's right. For more on that, let's go to field reporter Penny Wisnett. Penny, it looks like you're in an interesting location. Can you tell us more?
I'm here on location where you can see PEC's power lines. It's important that you stay away from these areas as they help deliver electricity to your schools and homes. However, this wide area here is called an easement. At PEC, we plant seeds like milkweed along some of the easements within PEC's service area to help feed and attract butterflies. This assists in their migration. PEC not only provides safe, reliable electricity, but we also do our best to conserve and protect the environment. What are some ways that you can help the environment? Pause here for a class discussion. Did you say by building a pollinator plot at your school? You're right. That's a great way to help the environment and the butterflies. We'll send it back to you, Celeste, to tell them more.
Thanks, Penny. Yes, there are ways you can help monarch butterflies too. Be sure to pick up your seed packet and build your own pollinator plot at school or home. Then visit this website to learn more. That covers it for this edition of PEC News. From all of us here, thanks and have a great day.